The Energy Cost Assistant, in short ECA, optimizes your battery management. It takes into account three things: your consumption patterns, your production forecast, and variable electricity tariffs, and adapts your battery management accordingly. In this video, you will find out how you get the ECA and how it actually works. To activate the ECA, you need three prerequisites. First of all, you need Solar.web Premium. Secondly, you have to activate the weather and yield forecast. And thirdly, you need to set a variable energy tariff in Solar.web. Please also don't forget to update your software regularly so that you have the newest version. How to get Solar.web Premium and how to activate the yield and weather forecast, there are already how-to videos. You find the links in the video description. How to enter the variable tariffs? This is what I will show you now. In order to enter a flexible tariff, you click in Solar.web on Settings. Then you click on Tariffs. And you add a reference tariff here. Then you select Flexible Tariff. And enter in this mask the date where it's valid and your energy provider. Finally, you tick your energy meter and you click on OK. In order to see how the ECA works, you go in Solar.web to Settings and Operation Mode. Here on the top right, you see that the Energy Cost Assistant is activated. Below, you find a switch that, when turned on, allows your battery to take electricity from public grid for charging. In advance, please clarify with your grid operator and energy provider whether charging the storage system from grid has an impact on subsidies or feed-in tariffs. Below you find a chart where you see how the ECA actually works. In order to show what it is capable of, we take the 14th of February. You see two charts here. Below you see in blue the consumption tariff of electricity. You see that this price, the price of electricity, was rather low in the morning, had a first peak around 8, then was again cheaper over the day, and in the evening at around 6 p.m. was again more expensive. On top, you see how the battery and how the PV system works. You see in green the SOC of the battery. In gray, you see consumption, and in yellow, you see the production. In blue, you see the commands of the ECA. You see that in the morning, between midnight and 3 a.m., battery was reserved and was stopped from discharging, although there was consumption. Between 3 and 5 a.m., the battery was even charged with electricity from public grid. Then again, it was blocked, and then when energy prices were high around 8 a.m., discharge of battery was allowed and energy was taken from there. Then when electricity prices got again lower, battery capacity was again reserved all over the day, until in the afternoon at 5 p.m., discharging of the battery was again allowed. So then when the price of electricity was high, there was still capacity in the battery and energy could be used from there. In the evening at 10 p.m., battery discharge was again blocked. So as you can see, the ECA takes the most out of your battery management and makes sure that you are taking advantage of low energy prices.